Thanks to Brilliant for supporting this episode of SciShow. Go to brilliant.org/scishow to learn how you can take your STEM skills to the next level. Also, as our usual disclaimer, this episode was filmed on November 17th, 2020, and you can find any newer COVID-19 coverage in the playlist linked in the description. It has been a big week for COVID news. In one corner, the Northern Hemisphere is entering flu season, so researchers are trying to figure out more about how these two diseases interact. Among other things, they're finding some early evidence that maybe a flu shot could protect you against both. Then, in the other corner, there's been a whole lot of vaccine news from companies like Pfizer, Moderna, and more. So, let's dive in. As far as flu and COVID goes, we do have documented cases of people getting both viruses at once. But there's a lot we don't know, including how common this is going to be. But if there's any good news, it's that some preliminary research is starting to suggest fascinating and encouraging things about the flu vaccine. We already knew flu shots have a huge impact on flu outbreaks. Like, the U.S. Centers for Disease Control estimate that flu shots prevented 7.52 million infections, over 100,000 hospitalizations, and 6,300 deaths in the U.S. during the last flu season alone. And that's because the vaccine teaches the body to specifically spot and eliminate multiple flu strains. But that's not all it does. It also seems that some versions of the flu vaccine may ramp up your non-specific immune defenses, a phenomenon called trained immunity. It seems like exposure to a pathogen, even the harmless versions in a flu vaccine, can ready the body's frontline immune cells. These may essentially become primed to react more aggressively in the presence of danger. And those faster, stronger reactions may help rally the immune system to fend off a second invader, even if it's completely different, like the virus behind COVID-19. A July preprint may even show this trained immunity in action. Preprints are scientific papers that haven't been reviewed by independent experts yet, so our understanding of their results might change. But since COVID is so new, they're all we've got to go on in a lot of cases. In this one from July, researchers analyzed over 92,000 confirmed COVID-19 cases in Brazil, and they discovered that receiving a recent flu vaccine was connected to fewer deaths and less severe infection overall. This isn't the only preprint suggesting that populations with good flu shot coverage have fewer cases and less severe COVID-19 infections. But like I said, this is only a preliminary study, and a flu shot is no substitute for a proper COVID vaccine. But as folks in the Northern Hemisphere head into flu season, it might at least be a silver lining. And speaking of vaccines, in the last week, multiple companies and organizations have come out with early results about their vaccines, from Pfizer and Moderna to groups from Russia and China. Each group is saying that their vaccines are doing really well, according to early results. But we're just going to focus on the Pfizer announcement for now, because that's where we've been getting the most questions, and where we've had the most time to, like, take in and synthesize information. On November 9th, Pfizer and their partner BioNTech announced some early phase 3 trial results courtesy of an independent data safety and monitoring board. According to the press release, getting two doses of their COVID-19 vaccine 3 weeks apart cut symptomatic COVID-19 cases in the trial population by more than 90%, which sounds amazing. But these are also really early results. They aren't even published in a preprint, so experts haven't been able to look at the study data. Also, that 90% figure is based on the first 94 infections that occurred within a month of the participant's first injection either of the vaccine or of a placebo. So that efficacy number may change as more data comes in. And of course, there's still a lot of unknowns, like whether the vaccine stops people from catching the disease or from being contagious, or just prevents infections from developing symptoms. So this is extremely encouraging, but also very preliminary. And there's an even bigger point here, too. Even if this vaccine is as effective as it sounds, getting it to everyone probably won't happen quickly or easily. That's because this is a brand new type of vaccine that uses RNA to essentially teach cells to spot the virus. And it's super fragile and needs to be kept very cold, like minus 70 degrees Celsius. For comparison, freezers in large hospitals are usually around minus 2 to minus 8 degrees Celsius. So some experts have warned that no one has the capacity to do this kind of distribution on a wide scale yet. And of course, this may be especially a big issue in rural areas and low and middle income countries. Now, not all COVID vaccines in development require these kinds of extreme temperatures, so maybe this won't be a problem we need to overcome. In the meantime, this is definitely a reminder that making a working COVID vaccine, though that is now seeming like an achievable goal, is just the beginning. And also, you know, get your flu shot too, which I did just the other day, and it went fantastically. Didn't even hurt the next day. There is a lot that goes into making a COVID-19 vaccine, and while we can't give you a tutorial on how to do it, we can at least say that Brilliant can hook you up with some pretty good biology courses. Brilliant's courses are designed by math and science educators and covers science, engineering, math, and computer science topics. If you like this episode, you might enjoy their computational biology course, which deals with subjects like genetics and evolution. To try it out, you can go to brilliant.org/scishow, and if you're one of the first 200 people to sign up there, you'll get 20% off the annual premium subscription, and you'll be supporting SciShow along the way.